My Boyfriend Die In Wuhan. This story is about a Chinese girl's love story that her boyfriend died in Wuhan because of COVID-19. And she shared the value of her boyfriend. Translate by, GM. This is my story. Around 11 noon on January 22, 2020. I went to the supermarket with my parent. Dongshan texted me on WeChat saying, "NuNu, I feel a bit tired. I want to go get checkup. I'm worried that I got infected by the disease." I told him to stop talking nonsense. Wuhan population is more than 10 million people. There is no way he would got infected. Dongshan was born and raised in Wuhan. We have been in love for 3 years. After graduating, I stayed in Wuhan to work. He is a programmer at a company, and I work at the design department at a fashion company. We both have a big dream, which is to make lots of money and buy a house. I studied, worked, lived in Wuhan for 7 years, because of Dongshan. I love the city. Dongshan families is in the countryside. My parents are farmers and they really oppose me staying in Wuhan. They really want me to go back to the province for work. Despite all that, I still choose love as my priority. I believe that the person I choose will give me a happy future. Spring this year, when the cherry blossom in Wuhan, we are planning to take a wedding photo and choose a wonderful to get marriage. At 4:30 in the afternoon, Dongshan sent a WeChat message to me telling me that were so many people in hospital today and he stood in line forever but still couldn't get the number. I asked him why he did not change to another hospital. He said that it won't make a difference. A lot of people is suffer from high fever. The hospitals are full. There are so many hospitals in Wuhan. How come it is all crowded? In his description, I can realize that this pandemic in Wuhan is really a disaster. I asked him what the symptoms were. He said, his whole body ached and tired. I hope that this is not a symptom of coronavirus. I was very worried. Advising him to go home with his parents was not the best right now. I remembered that my colleague, her husband seemed to be working in the hospital, so I hurriedly phoned her to ask for help if I could go to the back door, so Dongshan could see a doctor. She told me that her husband works in a private hospital, not accepting patients with fever. Dongshan could not get to see the doctor, and he was tired of waiting, so he went back home. I quickly took the phone to book a bus tickets. I had to hurry back to Wuhan. I had to stay with Dongshan, because he really needs me now. I booked a high-speed train ticket on January 24th. Around 11 p.m., my phone received a cancellation message, because Wuhan had just shut down its city. The ticket I bought this time was a stop in Wuhan. Wuhan has been sealed. The first reaction in my mind was that the epidemic this time compared to my imagination was far more serious. I could not sleep. I start a video call Dongshan. He lay on the bed, hugging the bear that I used to sleep with, on the closet beside some medicine. I asked him to call the local management. I saw the news that they could arrange an ambulance for medical attention. Dongshan told me, it does not work, their work is too much, they can only help those in critical situation. It is easy to understand. Because the sudden outbreak of plague caused the whole city to panic, they could not promptly prepare a safe and reasonable anti-epidemic mechanism immediately. The next morning, Dongshan said, he felt better. His body temperature yesterday was 38 degrees, now it has decreased to 37.5 degrees, and he is not tired anymore. Maybe he just have a slight cold. He is also telling me to rest assured. What a good news. But I'm still afraid that he might lie to me, so I asked him to video call me to see the temperature above the thermometer. As expected, the temperature did not rise. Deep down I thought to myself, my Dongshan is a generous, warm-hearted person, how could he got infected by such disease? Second day of Chinese New Year. Me and Dongshan made a promise to video call but he missed it. I called but he turned off the phone. I tried to WeChat him and didn't answer. I phoned his parents. His mom said, Dongshan did not go home, the whole family could not contact him. I contact the housing manager. The manager said the block in his area was blocked because it found many people infected with the virus. He said, "In the list of infected people, there is no name of my boyfriend." I breathed a sigh, but he said, "In the list of suspected people, there is a name, Dong Shine." I asked, "In suspected cases, how will the hospital handle it?" He said that the quarantine monitoring at home, the hospital is not enough space anymore, unless serious happen, then an ambulance arrived. I read the news on the internet, some people infected but did not go to the hospital and died at home, because there was no bed and died in the observation room of the hospital, and there are many other news about the patient who made my heart sink. The manager came to check our room, saw that Dong Shine was not at home. I was extremely impatient, but had no power. In the afternoon, Dong Shine called me again. My heart dropped at that time. Dong Shine is infected. He went to a nearby hospital for a checkup. The result is infected. But what worries me even more is that although Dong Shine has been admitted to the hospital, but because his condition is not serious and the bed is lacking, Dong Shine can only continue to stay in the observation room. Dong Shine said he could not blame the hospital. The disease situation is currently tense, the number of people infected with the virus is overcrowded but the beds are scarce. Therefore, doctors can only prioritize to treat serious or critical cases first. Seeing me crying through the video, he comforted me, "Do you know, when do you look the ugliest?" I scolded him, "Until now you were joking, waiting for me to come back to Wuhan and handle you." He laughed and said, "When you cried, you were the ugliest girl in the world." Oh my god, Dong Shine is so handsome and found an ugly wife like that, dot. Despite tears in my eyes, I also had to laugh. I think it is good to keep this optimistic mood for treatment, surely you will soon get through this gate. I really want to go to Wuhan, but I can't go anymore. After providing information that I returned from Wuhan, I was isolated at home. All members of my family were also quarantined. Every day, inspectors come to measure our body temperature at regular intervals. The 5th of Lunar New Year. Dong Shine suddenly video called me. He said, "NuNu, I don't think that I can continue to be with you anymore. I want to tell you something. But promise me, don't cry, be strong." In the video, Dong Shine still cannot lie in a hospital bed. My heart sank, a bad premonition appeared in my head. Dong Shine probably realized that he could not continue. I cried non-stop in front of the phone screen. Seeing the person I loved walk to the edge of death but couldn't pull him back, couldn't even meet once. I seemed to hear the sound of a broken dream. Yes, the dream of our house, the dream of the wedding, will all go to hell. At this moment, I don't want to hear Dong Shine say anything. Unless he say that he have a hospital bed, your body will be better. This is exactly what I want to hear most from the person I love. Dong Shine sent me a file of documents, saying that it was a letter he sent to my future boyfriend, who must definitely deliver it to him later. I opened it and my heart broke into pieces. A paragraph of the letter was written as follows. "When you read this letter, congratulations on being NuNu boyfriend. I am really jealous when you have the talent to win her heart. Here I just want to briefly tell you something important that you must remember. 1. NuNu sometimes somewhat stubborn, moody. You remember to yield to her. Yeah right, give up unconditionally because you are the man who will protect her forever. 2. NuNu always have a headache. At such times, you must take care of her, not to be annoyed. Every time she had a headache, I helped massage the temples. She will quickly fall asleep, after waking up there will be no more pain. This is the method that a traditional medicine doctor taught me, you must remember. 3. NuNu has a downside that I feel is not good. I always try to help her fix it but now I have no chance, leaving this task to you. She loves movies, most of time is very serious. Sometimes she will finish watching movie at 2 a.m. to 3 a.m. to go to bed. This habit is bad for health because there is not enough time to rest. If you love her, you have to fix this for her. 4. When you become her lover, it is inevitable that there will be obstacles. Hopefully you two can learn to respect and be tolerant of each other. 5. I don't know where you are, where you live and what you do. But those things are not important at all. As long as you genuinely love her as much as the love I have for her. Thank you for taking care of her for me. Wish you both the happiness. At the end of the document, Dongshan wrote a series of numbers, the password of his savings account of more than 100,000 yuan. That's all the money he saved from starting work. Dongshan also said, this whole life he only loves me, so this money is all for me. The 8th day of Chinese New Year, Dongshan is gone. He died in the observation room of the hospital, and until his death, he could not get a hospital bed. I cry out loud. I hate the heavens why they took Dongshan's life. Why rob the person I love? Why is he not in the hospital room? This plague has claimed the lives of many people. One person left, the city was the same, but no one knew how painful their loved ones were. No one knows that in the fight against the disease, the person I love the most has been gone forever. His name is Dongshan. The second day after Dongborn was born, the sunshine was bright and bright. But the sun's rays shining on my face only made the compassion more evident. One night after losing Dongshan, I dreamed of a frog jumping out of a cave in the cold winter night, jumping through the night, jumping through the dawn, crying miserably as if to tear up the gourd. God! I closed my eyes softly, tears gently falling down. Dongshan, I definitely did not know, Wuhan that night heavy snow but also could not dissolve his tires. Tears are the clearest evidence for the pain he suffered, pain that only blue sky see through. Dongshan, did you know that a week after you left, Wuhan changed? There are many beds in the hospital now, the bed has to wait for the patient no longer needs to wait for a bed. Why can't you stay a bit longer? If you could wait a few more days, maybe we won't have to wait until the next life to see each other. You are gone, who will worry about me when my stomach hurts? Who will rub me when a headache? Who will comfort me when I'm angry? We have an appointment in March to go to Dongho to take wedding photos when cherry blossoms are in full bloom. Appointed to try together, build our own home. But now everything has vanished. Kisses, smiles, tears, all gone. The cycle of love, it is all gone now. Now, in the middle of the road full of blooming cherry blossoms, the city lights are splendid, but it only makes me feel more and more painful to think of you, who is less than 3 inches below the ground. What should I do to forget you, to forget the pain that is so deeply focused on this mind? My lover, me and you, is inherently a beautiful love mournful. Yes, there is loss. Yes, there is constant crying, yes, there is laughter but in the end it was only a broken pain.